people named Don Juan and Namongan live in a faraway barrio of Narbuan. One day, Don Juan left his pregnant wife and went to the mountain to punish a group of igorots. While he was in the mountain, Namongan gave birth to a baby boy. The baby was different from other babies because he could already speak. He wanted his name to be Lam-ang. "Where is my father?" Lam-ang asked his mother. "He is in the mountain to settle his fear with a group of igorots," said his mother. Lam-ang felt sad. He hadn't seen his father since he was born, and he was terribly longing to see him. Would it be long before he came back? "I don't know," answered his lonely mother Namongan. "I don't even know if he is still alive." One day, Lam-ang had an unusual dream. In his dream, he saw how his father was killed by the igorots. He was sitting with anger when he woke up. He decided to follow his father to the mountain. He was 9 months old when he reached the igorots' village. He saw them dancing around in the head of his father. In his rage, he fought all the igorots and slew them all, including the leader of the group whom he tortured first. On his way home to Narbuan, he passed by the Amburayan River and take a bath. The dirt and blood killed all the living creatures in the river. When he was old enough to marry, he saw Ines Kanoyan, and he fell in love with her. He went to Ines' place to court her. "Oh, Ines, I love you, and I want to marry you," said Lam-ang. "I will marry you if your wealth could equal our riches," answered Ines Kanoyan. Lam-ang went home at once and came back with a tons of gold, the value of which surpassed Ines' family's wealth. After that day, they were married and lived happily. Year passed, and came Lam-ang's turn to catch a fish known as rarang. Lam-ang felt that he would be killed by a bird kahan, but he had to do his duty, and he sailed out to sea. He was killed by a bird kahan as he foreseen. Ines wept in sorrow. Ines Kanoyan paid a deep sea diver to locate all the bones of Lam-ang. The diver found all the bones very easily, and Ines put them together. She held prayer vigils every night, until one day, Lam-ang came back to life, and they lived happily ever after.